Another impressive crowd at TD Garden for a preseason game. Tonight's starting goaltenders brought to you by Netson 360. Darcy Kuemper was a workhorse last season. 57 appearances, had competitive numbers among the goalies who played 50 or more games. Linus Ullmark gets his second start of this preseason, coming off a Vezina Trophy year. Alexander Ovechkin isn't playing tonight, but David Pastrnak is. That's an impressive list, and as Brick pointed out in an earlier game, all of the players on that list, except for Pastrnak, were number one picks. The game is on. John Carlson back to the ice. Evgeny Kuznetsov to Connor McMichael through the crease. Rasmus Sandin in front of the Zamboni doors. Trent Frederick misses connections with Brad Marchand, and it goes for icing. Spencer Carberry, 41 years old, went to the University of Alaska at Anchorage and St. Norbert's College. McMichael scores on the juicy rebound from Carlson's chest shot off Ullmark. And 26 seconds into the game, the Bruins are chasing the score.
Yeah, not an ideal start for this Bruins team, and not really much to analyze on this. It's a face-off win in the offensive zone. It's a shot from the point that a rebound is led come right back out in front of the goal. The coverage is loose, the rebound available. McMichael gets right in between Forsberg and Shattenkirk. The shot from Carlson gets all the way through, and the rebound's allowed. You're down one.
Anthony Mantha can't keep it on his stick. David Pastrnak, stick handles into a thicket. McAvoy cross ice. Nicholas Backstrom. McAvoy clears. Zacha to Pastrnak. Cross ice. Van Riemsdyk scores!
Well, this starts about 10 feet inside the defensive blue line. McAvoy able to get to a loose puck first, bat it in the direction of where the support's coming from, make sure it's hard. And there's Zacha picking up that little touch pass. You attack three on two, attack the middle of the blue line, push the puck wide, and Pastrnak with a great feed, tape to tape to Van Riemsdyk. What a nice catch and release. Not all in one motion. He's going to stop it, pick his spot before Kuemper can get across, up high over the blocker, under the crossbar. You can see why Van Riemsdyk scored a lot of goals in this league from that distance.
Two goals in 27 seconds, and they're off. Heinen battles Vinny Iorio in the corner. Comes to Matthew Phillips, only listed at 5'8", as short as 5'7", in some listings. Megna can't penetrate the layers. Sonny Milano. Now Iorio to Lucas Johansson, the younger brother of Ryan. Iorio to Johansson. Good step up by Forbert on Malenstein.
Austin goals for number 21, Shattenkirk
lobs it in. And the play is offside.
Well, we'll go back to the goal. It's to tie this hockey game. You know, it was kind of an ugly start, an easy layup goal for the Caps. How are you going to respond? Well, you get a pretty good offensive line on the ice. I had a real quick look at the linesman to make sure that was onside. He waved it on. Obviously, no challenge coming. But what a pass from Pastrnak after Zacha makes the pass to the outside and drives the net in order to open up a little space in between behind him. The pass is perfect to handle. It allows you to really be in the position to shoot the puck. What a finish. Short side high.
John Beecher centers to Lucic. Nick Dowd takes it away and throws it past McAvoy. Mason Lowry takes the hit to move the puck. Jacob Lauko. McAvoy heads the rush. Lucic to Lowry. He scores!
Well, you just got to love everything about this, you know, and both defensemen having a hand in this goal. Lowry's got to get to this puck first. He makes a play up the wall on the backhand, absorbing the hit. Now the puck battle begins. The wingers do their job along the wall. Lauko's able to force that puck to who? McAvoy, who activates. Gain the line. Lucic slows down. He becomes an option for the drop pass and the timing for Lowry. He started that play from behind the goal line, Jack, and now he's up ice, and he's the finisher. He looks more and more comfortable the more he plays with NHL players. You know, it's just a great read, and this is exactly what Jim Montgomery wants. He wants his D involved as much as possible with the right decision-making. Timing's the key. McAvoy comes through with timing on the breakout. Lowry not afraid to come up, even though his partner's up involved in the rush. I'm coming as well. He ends up being that third layer in this instance. And again, getting the goaltender Kemper to move, it opens up holes. Those cross-ice passes are so productive when it comes to scoring goals in the NHL.
Two goals in a minute, 49 seconds. And the Bruins give up a goal in the first 30 seconds and make it up before the three-minute mark. Trevor Van Riemsdyk. Now Kuznetsov with Wilson going middle. Iorio. Vinny Iorio to Alexi Protas. The shot in and out of Ullmark's glove. Anthony Mantha can't retain possession. Derek Forbert to David Pastrnak. Mantha, a giveaway by Pastrnak. Mantha. Sandin, pressured by Pastrnak. Zacha didn't get the bounce. Pastrnak was gone. Johansson to Sandin. Sonny Milano has a three-year contract. Offside.
Well, David Pastrnak was the recipient of a bad pass by Joel Farabee against Philadelphia, where he was able to make a steal on a cross-ice pass. It was a 4-on-4. He walked in and scored a beautiful goal over the glove. Well, Pastrnak does that favor to Anthony Mantha. Mantha on the attack all by himself. I mean, he's a gifted player, big man, looks the part of, you know, the prototypical power forward with a tremendous skill. He walks right in. He picks his spot, blocker side. It looked like it changed direction, whether it was blocker or stick. Looked like Ullmark got a piece.
And the frame of the goal got a piece as well. Jason Megna tosses it past John Carlson, who, if he stays healthy, can get 1,000 games this season.
Yeah, missed 42 last year with a nasty injury.
Yeah. Grizzlick. Saboril kicks it deep. Trevor Kuntar is going to go for a high stick.
trying to get involved behind the net. The sticks were up high. Sometimes a stick gets helped up into a player's face when you don't mean to, but regardless, and I'm not saying that was the case, but they are having a discussion down ice level. Right now, Kuntar's in the box. They're trying to figure out if it's two or four. I don't think they're discussing friendly fire, that's for sure.
Rasmus Sandin glides back to the Washington bench.
I'm curious about this discussion, Jack, because it was the referee along the goal line, right by all the activity and all the stick work. He didn't put his arm up. It was the guy up in the neutral zone, the referee that made the call. And I think they're trying to have some kind of discussion as to, you know, what this call should be.
Kelvin Sutherland.
Yeah.
After discussion, it was determined it was a Washington stick that high-sticked his own player. We have no penalty on the play.
Kelvin Sutherland, an excellent communicator.
Yeah, tough to tell from behind Sandin. Just whose stick catches him in the face. And, you know, after further discussion, you want to get these calls right. Whose stick caught him? I know the Washington bench isn't happy with the call.
Well, that's Carlson's.
Yeah, that part of it certainly is. They're saying Kuntar's stick was up there as well.
Forensics is on the case. Spencer Carberry was an assistant for the last two seasons with the Maple Leafs. Lori catch and release, and that had some Chinese mustard on it. Carlson stacked up by Zaka. Lucic. Lori retains possession. Lauko tosses it to Lucic. Takes the hit. And it's offside.
Yeah, good shift here for Lucic. Right off the faceoff. You know, Beecher doesn't win it clean, but Lucic comes in and helps the centerman win the draw back to Lori initially. For that first shot, then he gets to a nice loose puck below the goal line. He went for the hard wraparound, thinking Lori would expect that possession play back to the point, but he was a little too much center on that blue line. He couldn't keep it in. And then Lucic takes a hit to get that puck back into the offensive zone, but unfortunately the play just offside.
The Bruins control the puck off Patra's draw. Brent Frederick in a puck battle. Trevor Van Riemsdyk, the younger brother of James. Here's Patra. Distributes to Marchand. Tries to return it. Haman Akhtel. Hardy Haman Akhtel. Originally a fourth-round pick by Nashville. Van Riemsdyk seeks Pasternak. Purtis pressuring Grizzlick. Good body position by Grizzlick to a much larger man. The twirling pass from Pasternak. Van Riemsdyk can't connect. Mantha to Protas. Van Riemsdyk up and down the ice they go at TD Garden.
Penalty coming
Van
up on Van
Riemsdyk. Knocked Sandin's helmet off. And the Bruins are going to be shorthanded. Well, the Bruins fell in a one-zip hole. James Van
Boston play number 21. 2 minutes for
and
roughing.
Mason Lorai have put the
entire high sticking penalty after a discussion by the officials. No need for discussion here. Van Riemsdyk coming down on Rasmus Sandin. Ripped his helmet right off the back of his head. Pulled it right over top. Can't do that. He'll go to the box. Power play caps.
Backstrom, Matthew Phillips on the near side. Tom Wilson in the slot. John Carlson directly behind Backstrom and Evgeny Kuznetsov in the middle of the zone. Megna takes the faceoff and wins it to Zboril. Forward number 10 in the NHL at shorthanded time on ice last season clears. Wilson's pass hits a body and Megna makes the 200-foot clear. Carlson drops it off. Kuznetsov carries into the Boston zone and Wilson's drop pass comes back to center.
Yeah, good idea by Wilson. Just put too much on the back pass.
Kuznetsov. Wilson. Forbert is without his stick. Yeah. Matthew Phillips. Backstrom. Wilson scores! Sweet triangle from Backstrom to Kuznetsov, the centering feed, and Wilson had time and space.
Yeah, even without Ovechkin as a threat on your power play, they still have plenty of talent. Kuznetsov, Carlson certainly. Wilson's going to get open in that high slot. It's a well-executed triangle. Backstrom, ever the great playmaker, his entire career, healthy now. Get an opportunity to get in real good NHL game conditions with Kuznetsov and Wilson. And, you know, on the entry, Jack, you said Forbert without his stick. Forbert thought it maybe should have been a penalty. He had his stick chopped right out of his hands. You know, it's not a penalty I'd like to see called, but they call it pretty regularly.
Yep.
Didn't come on that one. He got his stick back in time to defend, but it made for easy control for the Caps because he didn't have a stick.
Hardy, Hammond, Actel, Obey, Kubel, stolen by Beecher. Trevor Van Riemsdyk gets you to Obey Kubel. Lorai takes it away. Lauko to McAvoy. Lucic in front of him. Trip coming against Washington. And the Bruins have the power play.
Yeah, at first I didn't think they were going to call
number 96. 2 minutes for Trippi.
Thought there was a little bit of a delay with the arm going up, and maybe the referee just needed to get a better sight angle and, you know, get to some open space to put the arm up. And perhaps there was a decision to be made, and that's why there was a drag in the decision. We'll go back to this chop on the stick on Forbert. We've seen that called many, many times for a penalty. Washington gets the benefit of a non-call, and they make a well-executed, beautiful power play goal.
McAvoy indirect to Pasternak. Couldn't get through Kuznetsov. McAvoy to Zacha. Van Riemsdyk drops to McAvoy. Marchand, the one-touch cross ice. Carlson checks Pasternak and clears.
You'll see Washington do that. The minute they can attack Pasternak, they will.
Beck Malenstein hurls it around the boards. Ullmark pressured by Nick Dowd. Mason Lorai gains the line. Lucic drops to Zacha. Glove saved by Kemper, deflecting the puck over the bar.
Oh, nice rush by Lorai and a nice pass by Milan Lucic. Back into the high slot.
Marchand weaves into the Washington zone, gets the gift from Haman Akhtel. Matt Patra. Lucic guns it around. Marshawn. Patra. Lori. Marshawn. Lucic on the tip. The puck is bouncing and Kemper finds it.
Good quick puck movement by Boston with the man advantage here. Still 30 seconds to go. We'll go back to this rush by Lori. Carry the puck until you get challenged. Gain the blue line with ease. Lucic keeping that puck out in front of him, away from any kind of stick check. As he surveys what his options are, it's a veteran move. Finds Zacha in the high slot. Bruins get into their 1-3-1 setup, and Lucic is open briefly right at the blue paint. Got the little redirect. Even if you don't score on the redirect, lots of times there's a second chance opportunity for a rebound in tight.
Malenstein, a good individual effort. Nick Dowd battles Mason Lori. Heinen right there in support. Shattenkirk to Lucic. Lucic whirls it around. Shattenkirk off a leg. Lucic comes out of the right wing corner. Shattenkirk snaps the pass to Lori, and the puck made center ice.
Well, just 2 seconds left on the Obe Kubel penalty, so you got to be aware of that. Power play is going to be over. Face off in the neutral zone. Read and react as to who's got possession and what opportunities present themselves. As a defenseman, especially on this side of the ice, Grizzlick's got to take notice.
Iorio bounces it to the Boston zone. Jacob Zaborl feeds Matt Grizzlick. Johansson takes it away. Kuntar chops it cross ice. John Beecher. Now Grizzlick, the long diagonal to Kuntar. Lucas Johansson. McMichael and that's icing.
Just watching Linus Olmark, you know that puck was going to come back in his direction. He was tempted to go make a play on it and try to gauge where his defenseman was. Was he going to get to the hash mark? Were they going to call the icing, or do I need to go play it?
Vegna, Frederick, and Heinen with McAvoy and Lori. Frederick wins the draw. Heinen back to McAvoy off the end boards. Frederick muscles it loose. Tom Wilson sends Kuznetsov in. A great back check effort by McAvoy. Puck loose in front. Kicked out by Olmark. And he has it under the trapper. A spirited first half of the first period. 2-2 already.
Welcome back to TD Garden. Sophia Yurkiewicz here with you from our Nesson Studios on the fifth floor. And this is the last home game for the Boston Bruins before the regular season on October 11th. We are going to have pregame for you guys then, as well as postgame. And in first intermission, you guys should tune in because Bob Sweeney of the Bruins Foundation is going to be here to explain how you guys can win tickets to opening night, which you're going to want to come and see. The Bruins kick it off against the Chicago Blackhawks. Maybe you'll get a chance to see Connor Bedard, as well as how you can win a beautiful Bobby Orr golf cart that even if I won, I have no business riding because of how bad my golf has been. Right, Brick?
Don't be so hard on yourself, Sophia.
It's coming along.
It's tough.
Wow, tickets to opening night.
Yeah. That's going to be spectacular.
Yeah, I'm sure there's plenty of people that'll be in the house that were Taylor Hall fans, Nick Foligno fans.
Yep.
Not just Connor Bedard, everybody. Yep. Although that'll be fun. They do play the night before in Pittsburgh, don't they?
Yep.
Dark forward spoons it out. And Riemensdyk. Now Sonny Milano tosses to Hamann Akhtel. Shattenkirk clears the zone. Heinen, second effort, gets it deep. Trevor Van Riemensdyk. Hamann Akhtel. Van Riemensdyk, like his brother James, a UNH guy.
Ready? Coming back early.
The backs from the line out there. Anthony Mantha can't pick up the hot pass from Protas. Backstrom feeds Protas, and Grizzlick got a stick in there. Carlson slaps it to Protas. Dumps it in center ice. Mantha one-hands it ahead. Grizzlick intercepted Mantha. Carlson tosses it forward. Grizzlick with the stick again. Protas. Sandin. Mantha. Grizzlick on the stick for the third time in this shift. Zaka. A great diagonal cut. Sandin bounces off. Alexi Protas. Rasmus Sandin came over in trade from Toronto. Frederick on the forecheck comes up with it. Carlson pokes it away from Marchand. Frederick goes furiously to the corner. Mason Lowry into space. Obe Kubel gains the Boston line. Deflected by McAvoy, out of play.
Well, let's go back to, what ended up being a real scrum in front of Linus Ullmark. But it started in the offensive zone. Both McAvoy and Lowry were kind of creeping. All of a sudden, Lowry recognized that we need a safety valve. He backed off. But the Caps kind of had numbers off the rush. And despite the back-checking effort of Charlie McAvoy, he's got to make a decision. He originally said, I got the wide guy. But when separation happens in the middle, he's got to make a quick read and kind of get back and prevent a high-quality scoring chance. That's a good read, good skating ability, good recognition, good battle. And then everybody had to hang in there tight in front of the Bruin goaltender to make sure there was, no kind of layup or greasy goal.
Well, Mark snares the Obe Kubel shot. Charlie McAvoy poised for a stellar season. Shattenkirk through Lucic. Johansson gives it away at center. Shattenkirk around the boards. Lauko, Johansson tips it to Malenstein. Now Nick Dowd. Obey Kubel. Lucas Johansson to Dowd on his knees. Obe Kubel, who won a Stanley Cup with Colorado. Obe Kubel, Hamann Akhtel blocked by Lucic. Forward to Shattenkirk, D to D. Shattenkirk wanted Marchand. Tom Wilson curls away from Shattenkirk, flattens Patra. Wilson. And Riemensdyk. His net's off. Now McMichael chases Grizzlick. Marchand flips it to space. Matt Patra takes the hit from Sandin. Kuznetsov. Patra kicks it to Pasternak. The ref got in the way of that pass. Sonny Milano tries to get it to the onrushing Sandin. And Lorai makes the play. McAvoy's centering pass for Van Riemsdyk. Interrupted. Pasternak pats it ahead. Van Riemsdyk sets up. Good back check by John Carlson's 2-on-1. Sonny Milano with magical hands lifts the backhand glove side on Ullmark, and Washington leads 3-2.
Now the result of a turnover in the offensive zone to give the Caps numbers going the other way. I mean, they had defenseman John Carlson caught up ice, but now he's reading it like a forward on a back check, makes the steal. This is easy entry, potential 2-on-1. Ends up being a 3-on-2 from close range. Pretty soft hands there. Sonny Milano didn't really have an option right here. I think that pass far side is going to be taken away by McAvoy, so he went forehand, backhand. Ullmark deep in his goal. 5 goals in the first. We still got 4 minutes to go.
Shattenkirk indirect for Heinen. Johansson stabs at the puck. Johansson to Protas. The two wingers for Backstrom are huge men. Protas and Anthony Mantha. Iorio across to Lucas Johansson right through the slot. Kuntar bears off Iorio. Kuntar. BC product. Takes it back from Forbert. Aman Aktel. Now Mantha. Beck Malenstein dumps it into the Zboril's corner. They go hard into the boards. Zboril indirect to Grizzlick. Zboril finds Lauko. Tries to get it through to Beecher. Zboril stands up, Obe Kubel. Beecher swooping back for the puck, has Lucic middle. Lucic barrels into Haman Aktel. Haman Aktel cross ice, Lorai to Beecher. Quick re-entry, long reach, back to McAvoy, the shot. With Lucic screening Kepper. Lucic. Haman Aktel dropped his stick. Patra with the steal. McAvoy, Lorai. Puck comes back to center. Icing against Boston. This game has been up tempo.
Now tomorrow, take a look back at David Pasternak's historic 61-goal season on Pasta's season of goals, where he became only the second Bruin in team history to reach the 60-goal benchmark in a single season. Don't miss Pasta's season of goals tomorrow night at 9, only on Nesson. This is going to be a tough assignment tonight for a guy like Matt Patra. Well, you know, highlight him a little bit in the open. He's had a great camp, but you're talking about, I mean, his first shift, he's lined up against Kuznetsov.
Yep.
And it's back-to-back nights with travel. You travel on the same day. You know, not an easy task for a 19-year-old or for a veteran, for that matter.
The least experienced Caps center in this game has 7 years of NHL experience. Patra gives up at least 2 inches and 27 pounds to the foursome that Carberry has dressed. So this will be a test. clicking toward 1 minute to go in front of an energized crowd at TD Garden. Dylan Strome, Aspas Sandin, and hops over Shattenkirk's stick. Forward rescues his D pair. Zaka drop pass for James Van Riemsdyk. Pasternak tries to step middle. Sonny Milano, who had that great backhand goal. Aman Akhtel under Iorio's stick. Grizzlick had leverage on Iorio. Van Riemsdyk skips it out. Hardy Aman Akhtel, center circle, Malenstein deflects to the far boards. Lorai holds his ground. Jason Mega will run the clock to zero. 3-2 Caps after 20 minutes.
We talked to Jim Montgomery about slow starts the other night, last night. You know, slow first period. They didn't get behind, but the second period probably cost them the hockey game. They give up an early goal in period one. The response was good, Jack. Both goals off the rush were things of beauty. Pace, execution, good goal scoring. I liked Lorai and McAvoy together. They entertained me that 20 minutes. I thought Lucic had a good opening period, but their coverage in their D zone needs some work.
Sophie Yurkshevich in the studio with Billy Jaffe and Barry Peterson right after this.
Welcome back to TD Garden. The Bruins trailing the Washington Capitals 3-2 as we get ready for the second period. Well, before tonight's game, the Bruins paid tribute to Chris Snow, Russ Francis, and Tim Wakefield. We lost Tim Wakefield on Sunday morning. He's a Red Sox Hall of Famer, a World Series champion, a colleague to us at Nesson for a dozen years, and he was a friend to many of us as well. He was a good man who left a lasting impact on so many people, including Jeremy Swayman, who after last night's game in Philadelphia made a point to talk about Wake and talk about an encounter he had at a golf tournament a couple of years back. And he talked about how Wake taught him about the value of teammates, how they're your brothers, how they're like family. And he said that left a lasting impact on him. And he also inspired him to really stay in Boston this summer. Swayman was thinking about going back to Alaska. Instead, he decided to stay in Boston because that has become his home. Even though he's not from here, it's become his home. Just like Tim Wakefield, Boston became the home to him as well, guys.
Teammates are forever, Rick.
Yeah, not just a Red Sox Hall of Famer, but a Hall of Famer in life. And, you know, I echo those sentiments that Jeremy Swayman's talking about. I mean, simply put, when you talk to Tim Wakefield, you came away feeling really good about yourself. He had that ability to do that, even if it was in the shortest encounter, whether it was at a golf tournament or a baseball game or, you know, in a studio for us over at Nesson, you know, when your paths would cross. And what a tremendous human being.
Frederick tries to center. McAvoy all over the attacking zone. Marchand hacked away in the corner by Sandin, and Kemper smothers the puck. This, I'm not reaching, is the best first shift we have seen in the preseason.
Well, certainly in the last couple of games, you know, maybe the last eight periods or so. You're right. You know, I did love the response, though, the two goals they scored once they got down 1-0. That was huge. But, you know, when you're down 3-2 after the first, you know you got to clean up some areas. And the boys didn't have a lot of time in between periods to discuss it and break it down. And maybe between periods two and three, they can revisit that. But, yeah, we'll see if Boston can settle into a little bit more of a five-man defensive team. Whether it's in the offensive zone when you're turning the puck over, you got to minimize that, first of all, because that'll give numbers in the opposite direction. Do you have the structure in the neutral zone to handle any kind of speed that Washington wants to throw at you? And then your in-zone coverage. You know, the sentiment's so critical to what the Bruins do, you know, in their five-man defensive rotation. And that's going to take a little while because, you know, they don't have a ton of experience at that position.
Trevor Van Riemsdyk, and what hands by Matt Grzelcyk to control the flipping puck in the slot. Grzelcyk has been so good with the stick tonight. That is his trademark. Good stick by David Pastrnak, denying Trevor Van Riemsdyk of a one-timer. Anthony Mantha, drop pass to Lindstrom. Gets it back. Blocked by Trevor Kuntar. Heinen on the back check. Kuntar legs it out to the red line. Strom stops him. Lucas Johansson ahead to Strom. Centering off Iorio's skate. Jason Megna gains the line. Feathers a pass to Heinen. His shot blocked. Sonny Milano, 3-on-2, now 3-on-3. Heinen hits Kuntar, tape to tape, 2-on-1. Kuntar the shot, a Kuemper save.
Yeah, pretty good shift by that line. You know, even when they were in their own zone, no real danger on Ullmark. They sorted things out. They kept it to the perimeter. They created turnovers. And then a couple of good rushes up ice. Unfortunately for Heinen, who came late on a nice pass from Megna. Couldn't get a shot through.
As you were saying, five-men defense.
Yeah. And then Kuntar gets a nice two-on-one on a good breakout pass from Dan Heinen.
Charlie McAvoy gains the red line, dumps it in, goes off for a change. Jacob Lauko is nothing but energy on the ice. Every shift. Lucic, Forbert, Beecher off Van Riemsdyk's stick. Lucic bashes Obe Kubil. Shattenkirk off Frederick's stick. Iorio. Lucas Johansson. Tom Wilson picks it up. The shot and a save by Ullmark. Johansson centers. Wilson gets it back. Marchand steals the saucer pass. Gets the return from Mason Lowry. Deep for Frederick. It's off his stick.
He wanted to collect it and go right back to Marchand. Marchand just held onto that puck. Created space and time for himself. Everybody backed off. Kept it off his left hip. Fake shot. Nice pass to Frederick. Just couldn't handle it.
Carlson on a rink length rush. Runs into McAvoy. Zacha tries to spring Pastrnak. Sandin picked it off. Van Riemsdyk wrists it through the slot. His younger brother helps Washington get it out. Anthony Mantha closes, and it's off Grzelcyk and off the putt. Jason Megna tries to turn it into a sequence. Cross ice. Mantha deflects it to center.
Unfortunately for Mason Lowry, he lost an edge right in the middle of the ice in the defensive zone, which gave the numbers to Washington, led to that deflection off the crossbar.
Kuntar steps into Mantha. Grzelcyk through the center circle. Zboril to Kuntar, draws a penalty. And the Bruins will get the power play. A hooking called against the Caps.
Well, action at both ends of the ice in this pretty wide-open game at times. Mantha's going to get this
deflection for hooking
off the skate of Grizzlick because Lorio on the change was trying to get back in the middle of the ice. He lost an edge. And then this opportunity, this is a good shift by this line. Kutar's going to do the net drive. Here comes Heinen coming late. Just gets his shot blocked from a prime scoring area. And then a good play by Heinen to create this two-on-one. Again, Megda Kunta, good decision there to let that shot go. The passing lane wasn't there. And then off the rush again, they draw a power play with effort. Keep your legs moving. Keep driving. Keep trying to drive to the net. Protect the puck. If you don't get scoring chances, you will draw penalties.
Zacha, Van Riemsdyk, Marchand, Pastrnak, and McAvoy. McAvoy, James Van Riemsdyk hurls it off the boards. Van Riemsdyk trying to get it through the corner. McAvoy drops. Nobody's there. Pavel Zacha to David Pastrnak. Speeds down the right wing. Drops indirect for Marchand. McAvoy distributes to Pastrnak. Double teamed and Tom Wilson clears.
Yeah, we talked about it initially on the power play. They're going to attack Pastrnak every opportunity they can.
McAvoy drop past him. Matt Patra. Kevin Shattenkirk. Mason Lowry. Milan Lucic. Lowry to Shattenkirk. Off Haman Akhtel's stick and out of play.
Still plenty of time, 48 seconds. You got your second power play unit out there. Keep it simple. You're looking for at least two real good quality scoring chances. Create those two-on-ones. If you got to get to a loose puck to create that second opportunity, the effort's got to be there. The communication's got to be there.
Lucic hammers the puck to the boards. Danton Heinen cross ice. Matt Patra looks for a seam. Lorai to Heinen. Oh, Obe Kubel takes it high.
Yeah, it looked like Kuznetsov got his stick in the way of that shot attempt by Lorai towards the goal. Felled him in a hurry.
Washington head trainer is Jason Service. Oof. Washington has a violation on the faceoff. Beck Malenstein. Matt Patra wins the draw. Heinen to Lucic. Centering pass. Dowd in the right spot. Carlson skips it clear. Last rush of the Boston power play. Danton Heinen. On a professional tryout, still in camp. Shattenkirk reverses Heinen to Lorai. The tip by Lucic and a good save by Kemper. 12:22 to go, second period. Quite the entertainment factor for a
look at the latest Bruins news. They gear up for the 23-24 season on Bruins Back to Work, presented by Cross Insurance. Catch an all-new episode tomorrow night with Sophia and Brick at 6, only on Nesson. Kevin Shanker was a guest on Back to Work. He's back in the lineup as he gears up for his 14th NHL season, with the Bruins being his 7th team since he broke into the league as a 21-year-old coming out of BU back in 2010. When he was with us on Bruins Back to Work, talked about his evolution as a player. When he was young, he says he relied on his skating and offensive ability to carry him while at the same time learning how to defend the right way, which includes stick work and good positioning. That part of his game, guys, he says, has evolved the most.
You know that guy? Grizzlick turns into space. McAvoy scoops it corner. Iorio. Strome off a stick and paddled to the corner by Ullmark. Villano off a skate. Iorio waves it to Lauko. Lucic and deflected in by Milano. Lauko's relentlessness and Lucic tried to find Beecher.
Well, you take them any way you can get them, and when you're playing the game the right way, which Lucic has been all night long, you're going to get rewarded. And the Bruins have been better here in period two with straight line hockey, simplistic, legs are moving, people are driving to the net. Little exchange that was kind of ugly in center ice, but they just continue to pursue the puck. You know, pucks that deflect and bounce, and defensemen that are backing up, and it's in their skates, and they're not sure what to do with it. It's an advantage for the offensive team. Lucic tries to get that puck towards the net, hoping for a deflection. He got it from the other team, and it pays off.
Burris to Backstrom. Van Riemsdyk double-teamed. Heinen helped to take the puck back for Boston. Heinen hurls it toward goal. Kuntar, a good check on Haman Akhtel. Kuntar, the shot, a glove save by Kemper.
Yeah, just to go back to Kevin Shattenkirk and his opportunity that he has here in Boston. You know he's excited about wearing the black and gold, especially in a centennial year when having gone to BU and his connections with this town. But, you know, when you take a look at the makeup of the Bruins and where he fits, it's kind of in a sweet spot.
Yeah.
You know, he can be a power play guy, a second power play guy. He can play a third pair. He can have a little bit of freedom, you know, to play offense. If he's going to play with a Derek Forsberg type on his left side, he's got that veteran savvy, been around a long time. It's just a matter of, you know, picking up the systems, playing to his strengths within the system, and using his skill set to be a dangerous depth guy, meaning, you know, defenseman 4, 5, 6, whatever it might be.
Tom Wilson can't get it out. John Carlson. Wilson pursues against McAvoy. Carlson. Excuse me. That was McMichael, who quietly has 5 shots on goal. McAvoy. Pasternak retrieves. Lauri. McAvoy. Pavel Zacha trying for the doorstep tip. Lauri. Wilson takes him down.
Washington, number 43, 2 minutes hooking.
Looked like Lauri was in danger. That puck just scoots over his stick, and now he's in the neutral zone under pressure. And you can see why Wilson was unhappy with the call. He was just lifting a stick, making a play on the puck. Referee thought it was a hook.
Well, Spencer Carberry has a similar sentiment.
Yeah, he's yelling, hey, why don't you guys all get together and rescind that penalty?
Lucic to take the left circle draw. Aman Akhtel clears it 200 feet. Mason Lowry, Matt Patra, Danton Heinen picks up the puck. Kevin Shattenkirk and Milan Lucic are the other skaters. And the Caps clear.
Yeah, don't waste time on your power play with soft passes once you gain the blue line.
Lowry chips it over to Shattenkirk, twists it around. Heinen moves the puck smartly. Shattenkirk to Lowry. Heinen threaded the needle. Shattenkirk, Lowry's shot.
Hit Van Riemsdyk.
Yeah. He's hurting. Lowry. Heinen's shot, and Kuemper hugs it to his chest.
Lots to like about this power play. The second unit, what I liked the most was Danton Heinen. When he gets out by that left point, see that little pirouette he makes? When you're on the elbow side and you drift towards the middle of the ice, you got to arc so that when you receive that pass, you're on the attack net mode. And he keeps it right off that left hip. Everyone's expecting shot, fake shot. And he slid it far side looking for a forehand redirect from Kevin Shattenkirk. That's good execution.
How does Danton Heinen not make the team?
I think he's earned certainly the start. You know, I mean, I know there's another game in New York on, what, Thursday?
Yeah.
But he's an NHL player, Jack.
Yeah. Reliable, smart. Played for Jim Montgomery in college at the University of Denver. Nicholas Obey-Kubel back on the ice. Pastrnak skates it out. Feathers the pass to Zacha, cleverly handled. Marchand this way and that. Zacha comes to the puck. Marchand's saucer pass. A one-timer on the feed from Pastrnak. Marchand knows space and time.
Yeah, as does Pastrnak. And a little glimpse into what potentially could be an awesome first power play unit right there with that play.
Forward, hard off the end boards. It's up on the strings and next to the post. And Nicklas Backstrom skates it to safety. Dylan Strome hacks at the puck. Johansson lofts it into the Boston zone. Matt Grizzlick has had a solid game tonight. Forward. Johansson to Iorio. Backstrom. Iorio ought to pick up an endorsement for a cookie.
I thought you said you wanted him to buy a consonant.
Four vowels and one consonant in that name. Omar intercepted. Wilson hurls it around. Sandin on the line. John Carlson dipped by Wilson. Flips off the end glass. McAvoy to space along the boards. Trevor Kuntar scoops it. Jason Megna has a collision with Carlson to clear the zone. Zboril ices the puck.
We go back to that late power play chance for Brad Marchand. Good little pull up, hang on to the puck, use the bumper for, you know, possession, get it right back. Nice look here from McAvoy, and Pastrnak's on the move, not standing still. When you're on the move, seams open up. Tape to tape, one timer. Good stop by Kuemper.
Dylan Strome wins the draw.
Delayed penalty.
Carlson belts it off, and Glass, the extra skater, is on for the Caps. Sonny Milano through his own crease. Whoa. Carlson, and the play is offside, slash called against Danton Heinen. 5:50 to go, second
Boston
period.
Boston penalty number 43, 2 minutes for slashing.
We're 8 days away from Bruins opening night, and Nesson has you covered. You and our team for an hour of pregame coverage Wednesday, October 11th at 6 before the Bruins take on the Chicago Blackhawks on TNT. Then, Saturday, October 14th, we'll be back with our full game coverage from TD Garden starting at 6 against the Nashville Predators. And right off the face-off, keep your eye on 43 in black, Danton Heinen. That stick work right there, deemed a slash. He'll go to the box. We got 3-3 game. Caps on the power play.
Carlson, Backstrom, Wilson. Backstrom setting up Kuznetsov. Wilson bumps it back to Carlson. Backstrom to Kuznetsov. Backstrom looks for a seam. Kuznetsov rotates. Tom Wilson, Kuznetsov still on the perimeter. Carlson low for Phillips off Wilson's stick. Out of play.
Good discipline by the penalty killers, making the adjustments, trying to take away the bumper to Wilson for the shot. You know, if he wants to make a touch pass, go ahead and let him. You don't want to let him get shots away in that slot area. I thought he had a chance the initial time. He opted to go back to the middle of the blue line at the top of the umbrella. But better body position, better stick position to defend a very good puck possession power play.
Beecher and Lauko with Zboril and Schottenkirk on the PK for Boston. Kuznetsov on the elbow. Backstrom, Kuznetsov, Carlson, Kuznetsov. Carlson off the corner. Zboril makes the play to Lauko, a tumbling muffin, and Kemper paddles it out. Anthony Mantha, cross ice, Sonny Milano, Kuznetsov. Mantha gathers the puck. Bruins protecting inside ice, and Protas is wide. Sandin, Mantha, Protas. Mantha closes the shot, a save by Ullmark.
Yeah, I didn't love this change here by the two penalty killing forwards. The puck's in the neutral zone, and Beecher wanted to go, but both went. I mean, this puck's not deep enough to make a line change, because now you're going to give up something off the rush. I mean, there's just too many white jerseys on the attack. The Bruins try to take away the passing. Get a look at the high angle. There's your change. Now you're in real trouble. They do a decent job of saying, okay, we're going to give Ullmark the shot. Mantha can let it fly. Try to go short side high. Ullmark able to get it with the glove.
Strome wins the draw from Zacha. Grizzlick with the stick. Iorio. Strom over the center dot, lobs it in. Ullmark spills it out. Grizzlick, clever play by Pasternak, and Strom knocks down the saucer pass intended for Heinen. 5-on-5 now. Heinen drags the puck to the red line and spills it in. Alexi Protas back to Iorio. Beck Malenstein ices the puck. Protas, McMichael, and Mahlenstein are part of the Hershey Calder Cup winners at Hershey.
Yeah, seven-game final.
Patra. Frederick in support. Nudges the puck to forward. And Riemsdyk gets it back from Iorio. Dylan Strome to Van Riemsdyk across the face of the goal, and Ullmark makes a lunging save, makes a save on the rebound with his leg. Sandin indirect, Obey Kubel. Nick Dowd in the corner. Patra turns over the puck. Dowd, Van Riemsdyk. Deep for Mahlenstein. Patra checked to the ice by Van Riemsdyk. Pops right up. Marchand looks over his shoulder and runs into Dowd. A save and another by Ullmark. Matt Patra off Marchand's stick, and Bruins get a change. Tom Wilson can't keep the puck flat, and a couple of saves by Ullmark.
Yeah, that's five in a row for the Bruin goaltender. This sequence of stops huge in a 3-3 game late in the second period. The one on Abe Kubel was, I know he's a right-handed shot, and he's trying to one-time it on his back end, but Ullmark had to get across.
His nets off, swoops to the corner. Lapko tape to Mason Lowry. Ahead for Beecher. Amanaktel got a piece of that. Lucic, not enough steam on it for Mason Lowry. Kuznetsov centering pass out. What a save by Ullmark. Robbing Connor McMichael with 1:02 to go, second period. Blocker saved by Ullmark.
Boston Pelly, number 73.
As we head to the third, a shout out on Sophia, well, Brooke Sophia Zecello's 14th birthday. I've called her Sophia since birth. She and little sister Juliana are hoping for a Bruins win tonight. And Mom Melissa has done a marvelous job while her husband, our coordinating producer, Brian Zecello, has been going to hockey games all these years.
If not that, he's been playing golf every day.
Well. So we highlighted three rookie wannabes in the open.
Yeah, and if you take a look at their performance through 40 minutes, Patra, it's been a tough slog. You know, back-to-back games, fourth game of the preseason. You're going up against four experienced centermen. The time and space really hasn't been there tonight, but he's battled and he's hung in there. He's done a nice job in a face-off circle. John Beecher, I thought his skating game has been very good. That's his number one strength. Had a good net drive on the Lucic goal. Anytime you're on the right side of the plus-minus, you're getting the job done. And Mason Lowry teamed up with Charlie McAvoy on the back end. Looks real confident. You know, said it early in the game. You know, he looks like a better player when he plays with NHL caliber people. Seems to fit more, you know, to that style, which I totally understand and totally get. And he's been very good here this evening.
Beecher, a great job on the PK to open the third. Mason Lowry strokes it down deep. Half a minute to go on the Washington power play with McAvoy in the box. Kuznetsov has had a strong game. Backstrom, Lowry shuts down that seam, and a tip by Tom Wilson. or Nick Backstrom. It's Backstrom.
Well, Forbert tried to be real aggressive on the wall. He tried to chase down Kuznetsov once they gained entry in the offensive zone. And when you chase out that high, now you got to try to recover. And, you know, the scramble's a little bit on. Well, and even though you kind of get back into a box formation, there's too much time, there's too much space, there's too many options for a quality power play team like the Washington Capitals, even with the absence of Alex Ovechkin. And we've seen that a lot from 74. John Carlson got a bomb of a shot. It's accurate. It's usually on goal. He moves well. And he just tees one up from the top of the umbrella, finds the back of the net.
The deflection with off Lowry's stick. The Bruins try to have a quick answer to that. McMichael, who has 7 shots on goal. Strome to Milano. A rebound off Olmark's save. Zacha. Fly pattern. Pasternak can't get to it before Kemper. McAvoy with Marchand to his left. Marchand cuts back. Deflected out of play.
Yeah, you just think about, you know, all the tremendous talent across the National Hockey League and some of the potent power plays when you start talking about the individual talent that you throw together. But Washington, you know, what a nice blend they have when you think about the 5-man first unit for that team.
Patra back to Lowry. McAvoy tosses it to the corner. Marchand comes out hard. McAvoy to Marchand. McAvoy takes it to the corner. Malenstein shuts him down. Patra gets a stick in. Dowd turns. Finds Malenstein. Back to Rasmus Sandin. The wrist shot. Lowry deflected it off back glass. Funky bounce. Patra. Kemper will play the would-be icing. Anthony Mantha off the boards. Nick Backstrom in on Olmark.
Yeah, McAvoy tried to take that puck deep on a rotation. He cut in behind Marchand, took the drop pass. He thought he had a chance to beat his man to the outside. Malenstein does a nice job getting a good angle, a good size guy, good skater. He got the leverage, and you can see the leg positions and the shoulder exposure in a situation like that. You're not really in a position to defend yourself and absorb the hit. And probably a little pain management going on the bench right now.
Lauko Springs Beecher, a save by Kemper. Forbert's shot. Protas cross ice. Mantha, a breakaway, and Olmark paddles it out of his crease. Beecher.
Oh, 2 unbelievable chances by explosive skating at each end of the ice. It started with Beecher. He just blew by everybody. Went backhand, forehand. Kemper made the save, and then Mantha at the opposite end. See you later. Left everybody in the dust. And Olmark makes the save.
Zboril backhands it into the middle. Danton Heinen. Wilson is offside.
Well, we just got through talking about John Beecher, a guy we highlighted in the open. He's just going to explode right there. Nice little pass on the backhand by Lauko. No chance stopping that guy. Not Rasmus Sandin. He wasn't going to get to him. And then Anthony Mantha, another one of these guys with those long, powerful strides. Couldn't get Omar to bite on the forehand backhand move.
Anthony Mantha goes 6'5", 234, and that's a lot of mass. Saka, Pasternak, and Van Riemsdyk. Saka wins the draw. Lauri to McAvoy, who's right back on the ice. James Van Riemsdyk. Charlie McAvoy elevates the pass to Pasternak. Now Lauri. Pasternak cuts back. Good stick check by Connor McMichael. Trevor Van Riemsdyk up the wall. Zaka against Van Riemsdyk. Haman Akhtel ices the puck.
Yeah, I'll see if Boston can take advantage here. Get a matchup you want in the offensive zone. Caps got to stay on the ice. Not sure they've been out there that long, but at least you get a matchup that you want.
Matt Patra taking the right circle faceoff. He's 4-for-4 in attacking zone faceoffs tonight. Kuznetsov warned. Patra's second effort. Frederick battles Van Riemsdyk in the corner. Marchand in the mix. Comes back to Grzelcyk. Tosses the puck cleverly to Marchand. This way and that. Loses Van Riemsdyk off Wilson's stick. Forward in support. Patra dangles and scores! Matt Patra! Wow! Spectacular spin move out of the corner and pots it.
Oh, that says a lot about this kid's compete, a lot about his character. We talked about him, too, how tough it's been tonight going against four experienced centers. He's hung in there, did the job in the face-off circle. Hasn't really created a ton offensively, but right here, good play by forward to throw it down deep. One-on-one coverage, spin away, and when the Caps all grabs, you know, a different Bruin, now that one-on-one coverage is on his backside, and he recognizes that, and he attacks the net. That's Kuznetsov. Not enough effort on the back check by Kuznetsov. Patra feels it, senses it, attacks the net, and just flat out beats the Washington goaltender to tie the hockey game.
In the third period of a teenager's back-to-back, Kuntar denied. Kuntar on the boards. Tries to self-pass and it worked. Pass offline for Shattenkirk. Sonny Milano shoots and Omar makes the save.
Yeah, you know, all the attention is on the goal scorer in that situation. That's not to diminish the great effort out high by Brad Marchand, controlling the puck one-on-one himself. Yeah, you know, that's a dangerous area where he might turn the puck over, 5-7, 10 feet inside the offensive blue line. All the confidence in the world that that's not going to happen and continue to make plays. Hang on to the puck and make a play.
Good play by Mason Lauri to take Nick Dowd's space away. Lucic goes for a tumble. McAvoy's shot off Obey Kubel's stick into the netting. Matt Patra ties it up.
celebrating 100 years of hockey. Individual tickets for the 2023-24 season are on sale now. Don't wait to secure your spot to all the hard-hitting action as the Bruins celebrate their centennial. Visit bostonbruins.com/tickets. Well, we'll go back to the tying goal, 4-4. Nice little rotation out high. Forbert had gone down deep, and he read that Marchand was going to be forced towards the board, so he goes back to protect, throws it down. Now it's one-on-one coverage. Caps are all in man-to-man. Paltra recognizes that, feels that I lost my man. I got some separation on the spin move to the backhand. Now I need a lane to the net. It's there. Take advantage. You do all the right things, and you get rewarded.
Nick Dowd. Trevor Van Riemsdyk feeds it to the middle. McAvoy breaks that up. Lowry twirls to the corner. Obey Kubel. Lauko had the board sealed off, and now he hustles back. Obey Kubel poked away by McAvoy. Lucic uses his body well. Bruins change. Artie Haman-Aktel gets the bump back from Protas. Johansson off the strings. Protas, Iorio. Johansson blocked by Van Riemsdyk, out of play.
You know, in the five games that the Bruins have played, you know, as far as team building and just situational hockey, there's been a lot of it. You know, there was an overtime shootout game, you know, so that means there's been 3-on-3. Shootout situations. There's been plenty of specialty teams. There's been pulled goaltender situations, 6-on-5. They've chased the score. They've played with the lead. They shut out the Rangers in game one. So some situations that guys are getting familiar with.
Vinny Iorio. Backstrom gains the line. Goes at Grizzlick. The shot by Iorio, blocked by Forbert. Marchand to Patra. Sends it to the corner. Marchand frees it. Mantha. Kuznetsov paddles it over. Shattenkirk. And thanks to Trevor Kuntar's hustle, that's not icing.
Yeah, he took a good lane and got inside position way out by the hash marks.
Jacob Saburl. Danton Heinen flips it in deep. Tom Wilson with space. Connor McMichael to Wilson. Ullmark makes a doorstep save. Heinen blocks. Kuznetsov to Milano against the grain. Van Riemsdyk blocked away. Mason Lowry can't get it past Dylan Strome.
Wilson had a chance on, you know, it's not a classic give and go, but essentially it's a give and go. It's kind of a drop pass, and I'll keep going on the net. The Bruins had a breakdown in communication.
Strome rattles it through the crease. Van Riemsdyk ahead for Pasternak, and that is not a hook. Wow. It's a water ski. Grizzlick. Great one-handed pass. Pasternak gloves the puck down. Iorio Pasternak, a tip by Van Riemsdyk through his own skates. Milano, Johansson, now Strom, lasers it deep. Holmark, miscommunication with Grizzlick, Obi Kubel. Zaboral taps back, and Malenstein is robbed by Olmark. Beecher, two-on-one with Lanco, tries to get it over, and Sandin breaks up the two-on-one. Lucic against Malenstein. Carlson overskates it. Malenstein forward for Dowd, protecting the puck to get it deep. Shattenkirk gets it back. Marchand bounces it into the zone, and it's a holding call against Washington.
Van Riemsdyk,
I believe. Penalty number 57, 2 minutes for holding.
The Bruins go to the power play with a chance to take.
Still tied at four here, more than halfway through the third period. Here's a couple reasons why. Simple little give and go off the rush. Tom Wilson, it's a backhander in tight. Great stop by Linus Solmark. And then a good forechecking play right here. A little behind the back pass. Dead center. Malenstein has a great opportunity. Solmark makes the save there. Brad Marchand trying to stretch the neutral zone, get away from his check. That's Trevor Van Riemsdyk. Referee said you're guilty of a hold. Bruins on the power play.
Eight and a half to go in a 4-4 entertaining preseason game. Saka wins the draw. McAvoy to Marchand. McAvoy, Pasternak, Van Riemsdyk. Marchand to Van Riemsdyk. Pasternak, the reach. Tape to tape to Van Riemsdyk. Out to Marchand. It's off Malenstein and out of play.
Again, the aggressiveness on Pasternak, forcing him to move the puck quicker than he wants to, but he's able to maintain possession, team possession, get it quickly down to Van Riemsdyk, transfer the puck side to side to Marchand. Marchand tried to sell the pass back to McAvoy in order to create the seam back to Pasternak. Just hit a skate.
Kuznetsov wins the draw. Pasternak confronts Wilson. Marchand to McAvoy. Pasternak. Not much space, and he gets the shot through. Tom Wilson sends it down the ice.
Yeah, good effort there by Pavel Zacha. Not allow any kind of outnumbered situation shorthanded.
Pavel Zacha. Marchand in a battle with Malenstein. McAvoy, the keep in. Van Riemsdyk. Pasternak backhands it around for Marchand. McAvoy's one-timer blocked out high. McAvoy to Pasternak. The bullet, a save by Kemper. And Haman Akhtel clears it.
And the Capitals being aggressive on the Marchand side, and that allowed the Bruins to free the puck up to McAvoy. Pasternak gets open for the classic one-timer.
Matt Patra had the puck get away. Kuznetsov on a semi-break, doesn't get a shot off. Heinen feathers the backhand to Patra. Shattenkirk tape to tape to Lucic. Centers, Heinen misses wide on the one-timer. A power move by Milan Lucic. Heinen wins the race to the puck. Five on five. Lucic blocked by Van Riemsdyk, fresh out of the box. John Carlson laterally for Dylan Strome. Shoots, saved by Omar, a save on the rebound. Haman Akhtel blocked by Patra. Patra is slow to get up. Dylan Strome saved by Omar. Phillips deep. Haman Akhtel puts a dent in the end boards. Iorio. Patra makes the defensive play, and Frederick muscles it out to center.
You got to still dig deep. Not enough time to get off.
Matthew Phillips tries to shove it middle. Shattenkirk is wise to that. Phillips robbed on a great lateral move by Ullmark.
Wow. What an endurance shift that was for the Bruins defensively.
Iorio rushes the right wing. Grizzlick checks him. Backstrom has the puck back. Iorio's one-timer, a save by Ullmark, who has been stellar. Lauko to Grizzlick, a tip and a save by Kemper. Up and down the ice they go at TD Garden. Protas. How did Matha miss the open side? I think it hit the post or something. Van Riemsdyk.
He had all day in an open net.
Kuznetsov drags it back across the blue line. Anthony Mantha had the go-ahead goal on his stick. Boston Bruins preseason hockey on Nesson is brought to you by Fubo, the proud sponsor of the Bruins. Try free at FuboTV.com. And by Subaru of New England and the redesigned 2023 Subaru Ascent. Well, Anthony Mantha won't have many better chances.
No, and the Bruins are hemmed in their own zone for an incredible length of time, and all they could do with great effort was force that puck just outside the, defensive blue line, and they still couldn't even change. Couldn't even change one guy. And they just had to dig deep and hang in there and hope for saves and hope for a post on an empty net if you had to.
Hand pass. And the faceoff will be in the neutral zone.
Yeah, and in that sequence, we talk about this kid's compete level. That Patois right here. Everybody's kind of lost in coverage. What are we doing? They're all sagging to the slot. He lays out, makes a block. Bruins catch a huge break here in terms of the score of the game. Empty net for Mantha, and he hits the post.
Sandin to Carlson. Up ahead, Connor McMichael. Laura, the stick check. Laura wins the puck along the boards. His net's off after it. Danton Heinen springs Jason Mechner. And Heinen centering pass to Znetsov. Sandin, the defenseman. Zaboral checks him. Kuznetsov steps into the crease and Ullmark pokes it away.
Yeah, Bruins get on the wrong side of the back check here, and Washington's just going to power their way to the net. We'll keep an eye on Ullmark and how he plays this. Bit of a strong stick out in front of him as he lays that right pad on the ice to disrupt that backhand forehand move. Get a look at it here. He knows he's got a little help from Grizzlick in front, but he wants to be strong. Got to make sure you don't pull off that near post too soon. Try to stay big. Nothing short side trip over that left shoulder. Use your stick and pad.
And Riemsdyk. Now Milano on a tour of the attacking zone. Van Riemsdyk. Hamann Akhtel. Matthew Phillips centers. Phillips buried on the forward check. Kevin Shattenkirk bounces it out.
Yeah, Lucko needs to make a better decision with that puck. Just threw it right back to the Washington Capitals. That's going to be 100% play out of the zone.
2.5 minutes to go. Zacha overpowers Dowd. Dowd gets the bounce. McAvoy. Ahead for Van Riemsdyk. Iorio intercepted by Zacha. Lucas Johansson. Both teams change. The Backstrom line comes out. With Backstrom past Trent Frederick. Grizzlick back to retrieve. Marchand. It bounces over Zabol's stick. Backstrom against Marchand. Centering pass. Carlson throws it through the slot. Sandin. McMichael. Another shot. And Omar makes the stop.
Now, when the Bruins have gotten in trouble in the defensive zone, and they've had their share of shifts where they have, it's been plays like this where two defending players go to the same player with the puck. And good teams will take total advantage of that. It happened once. Here it happens again. That leaves Omar all by himself to handle the shooter, which he's able to do to keep this a 4-4 game. But you know, those switches in the communication, that's something you're going to have to work on. You got plenty of time to work on it between now and October 11th. But those days will go faster than you think.
Connor McMichael, who spent the vast majority of last season in the AHL, has 8 shots on goal. Beecher throws it past Carlson. Centering pass goes right through the crease.
1 minute to play in the period. Last minute of regulation play.
Heinen in the final minute gets checked to the ice by Sandin. Matthew Phillips tosses it forward. Charlie McAvoy. Pasternak going up the right wing. Mason Lowry to Milan Lucic. Van Riemsdyk goes for a tumble. Zacha tries to pry it free. Zabol blocked by Malenstein. 15 seconds to go. Zacha cross ice. Zabol spoons it forward out of Pasternak's reach. 5 seconds to go. Tom Wilson spins it. Malenstein. And the siren sounds. We go to overtime.
Entertainment. There was some entertainment tonight. Some competition. Some good, some bad. A lot of good, actually, from a lot of different players. You know, you look up and you see four against. You say, oh, how is Omar? He was very good. So we'll have to try to solve this one in OT.
Stay tuned.
We'll take a quick look at Linus Ullmark and his body of work to this point here through three periods. You know, one thing the Bruins did a pretty good job of last year, actually a very good job, was limiting the, you know, the high danger chances, which always makes goaltenders very comfortable. Has not been the case here in training camp. They've given up a lot of high danger chances. Omark faced a number of those tonight as the Bruins try to sort out their defensive zone coverage with some new faces, some young guys. Not a full NHL lineup by any means, nor does any team really this time of year. And the goaltender's getting the working.
Darcy Kuemper has made some spectacular stops as well. Matt Patra, Brad Marchand, and Charlie McAvoy against Evgeny Kuznetsov, Tom Wilson, and John Carlson. 3-on-3, 5 minutes of sudden death. Carlson drops to Kuznetsov. Wilson looked offside. Kuznetsov on a tour of the attacking zone with plenty of space. Kuznetsov winds up and Patra blocks that to the end boards. Carlson draws it out. Carlson to Kuznetsov. Through Marchand, Wilson, a save by Omark, and Wilson has his stick in the air, and the washout.
Looks like the puck is still under Elias Omark. It looked like the Bruins were going to force the turnover out high in the defensive zone, but Wilson with a quick stick and a strong stick is going to keep the play alive for the Caps. Right here, it looks like they're in trouble. Right there, able to blow by Patra, and it's just Wilson and Omark all by himself. He tried to sell the goal by raising the stick. It broke through, no question about it. It broke through Linus Omark, but I don't think it ever crossed the goal line, do you?
Video review.
Not from the two angles that I've seen. The overhead's not going to help because I think Omark lays back on the puck. It definitely breaks through the five hole, and it's trickling. And as a goaltender, you could feel that. You could feel that puck as you lay back. And when I saw Omark roll off the puck, now that's the in-net camera. When I saw him roll off the puck, well, after the whistle, I saw it still in the blue paint, so.
Inconclusive. There's a 215-pound body over the puck.
Yeah, the call on the ice, we should reiterate, there's no goal.
Yeah.
But Boston never had possession in those 48 seconds. They just never had it. Let's go.
Morgan McPhee.
The puck does not cross the goal line. Therefore, we have no goal.
Man sticking around to see the end of this.
Yeah. The heck with the late train. Beecher, Frederick, and Lorai. Again, Washington possesses the puck. Beecher. Sandin, the backhand, and Lorai makes the play defensively, and then the puck gets away. Dylan Strome was saved by Omark. Bruins have had possession of the puck for about 3 seconds, and Omark denies McMichael on his ninth shot on goal. Milano has a goal tonight, and it was a pretty one. Backstrom to Sandin. Keeps possession. Backstrom to Carlson. Nick Backstrom. Carlson faced with Beecher. Backstrom. Milano. Milano feathers it across the slot. Backstrom. Milano. Keeping it moving to Kuznetsov.
Here's a clinic by Washington as far as possession, getting fresh bodies on the ice. Bruins are exhausted.
Yeah. Nearing 2 minutes, and Omark makes a no-rebound save, and three exhausted skaters.
How is this game still going? Omark, that's the reason. It's been unbelievable here in OT. Little cycle game. In tight, right pad stop. They take the puck in the neutral zone. They re-attack. McMichael, shot number, was it 9 or 10?
I have with 9.
Okay.
Patra races away from Tom Wilson to Marchand. And the play is offside.
And Marchand trying to stay ahead of the back check. Entered the offensive zone a little too early. Patra doing a nice job there, getting separation, attacking, left side of your screen. Marchand trying to take that inside route, have that little delay, stay onside. Couldn't do it.
Patra will sleep well tonight. Back-to-back efforts with travel. Kuznetsov controls. Marchand knocks down Sandin. Wilson covers the puck. Marchand again checks Sandin. Tom Wilson, who almost won the game. Rasmus Sandin. Matthew Phillips, a water bug, takes it back. Pastrnak gets checked to the ice. Less than a buck and a half to go. Carlson strides toward the slot. The puck bounces. Pastrnak. Carlson fights it in on Omark. McAvoy to Zacha. A save by Kemper. Carlson to Phillips. Final minute of OT. Phillips scores. Matthew Phillips stands tall, the smallest player on the ice tonight. Wins it for Washington.
Does all Washington in the OT except for the one real good chance Boston's going to get before this game ends, and that was off the stick of Pavel Zacha. Zacha goes indirect, nice pickup, stayed onside by McAvoy, pull it back, delay. This Zacha gets open. Good stop at the left pad by Kemper, who wasn't called on much in the final 5 minutes. Not sure what Pastrnak was doing here defensively. I don't know if that's a fatigue play or what.